Hey guys, for the last few days, I've had early access to the fourth new skill tree for Flak. This new skill tree introduces a new loaderbot pet and a new action skill that gives you a gravity trap. I was able to put together a loaderbot build that is absolutely insane and one-shots bosses. Right there, the loaderbot shot one bullet and did a critical hit of 212 million. And it doesn't stop there. This loaderbot will go in and wreck an entire takedown. Guardian takedown, Malawan takedown, this thing can do anything. And I have a very specific build that makes that happen, and in the next video I'm going to show you guys all of the stuff that I've put together for this loaderbot to make it extremely overpowered. This fourth skill tree and the other three characters' fourth skill tree is not going to be available until November 10th. That's when the Season 2 Pass releases, and you'll have access to this along with a new game mode and other cool stuff that's coming. So in this video I'm going to do a breakdown of the fourth skill tree for Flak and then show you some gameplay of different options you can use, and then in the next video, I'll show you guys this insane build, and then a couple of more videos showing you guys how I got through the Guardian takedown with this bot doing everything, and then the Malawan takedown as well. This guy will go in and melt all of the bosses while you just stand there and watch. So for the fourth skill tree, it's a purple color, and the pet you get with this one, obviously, is a loader bot, and it starts out as an ion loader. So this version of the loader bot is given a shock sniper rifle and also homing shock orbs. When you issue an attack command, the loader bot will shoot out this orb, and then you can shoot it and it will create a shock nova. Also, this version of the loader bot gives Flak increased elemental resistance of 30%. This loader bot can be upgraded to two other different versions, and I'll show you guys what those are and what they can do. But first, I'll quickly show you what all the skills are and which ones are my favorite. So with all of these skills, I've maxed all of them out, so you can see what the percentages are going to be when you've put everything into it that you can. So the top left is Gotta Go Fast, and this says Flak's pet gains increased movement speed and damage, and pet damage is plus 35% and pet movement speed is plus 40%. This one for me is a must for the build that I like because I'm trying to get the pet to do as much damage as possible. The movement speed for the build that I use isn't important. My bot stood pretty much in one place the whole time and he was fine, and when he did move, he didn't look like he moved all that fast, even with this plus 40%. The next one is Success Intimate. Whenever Flak's or their pet's shield breaks or is filled, they and their pet create a radiation nova, and then this skill has a short cooldown. I didn't use this one because I had a shield that was doing novas and did this same kind of effect, so I felt like I could put my skills in other places that helped me. The next is Agility Training. Yes, I definitely wanted this one. Flak and their pet gain increased reload speed. When it's maxed out, you get a plus 40%. This one I definitely liked because I had my pet doing all the work, so I wanted him to be as tanky as possible. Better toy. So Flak and their pet gain increased shield recharge rate and improved shield recharge delay. When it's maxed out, you get a plus 18% recharge rate and a minus 24% recharge delay. This one I did not use because I set up the build to be hands-free, where the pet does everything and I don't really have to help out a whole lot. This one's called Combat Veterinarian, and basically whenever Flak shoots the same enemy that their pet is attacking, then the pet gains a portion of the damage dealt back as health, and it's basically a life steal. It's only 1 point, and they get 30% of damage dealt. Also, I had another skill on from another tree that was making the bot invincible, so this one wasn't needed at all. This one I did like and used, Throat Ripper Hunter skill. Flak's pet's attacks have a chance to score a critical hit, dealing increased damage, and it has a critical chance of 15%, and this takes 3 skill points. This one I did not need because my bot was practically invincible. This one's called Lethal Force Authorized. Basically, whenever your bot goes into fight for your life, it turns into an exploder loader and seeks out an enemy and then self-destructs. It will deal damage of over 58,000 to nearby enemies, and it does help the pet respawn time. This next one is my favorite out of the entire skill tree, and it has a ton of potential. It's called Take This. Flak's pet gains a copy of Flak's shield. I had the stinger shield on, and yeah, it made my bot pretty amazing. And this next one is a must, called Monkey Do. The bot will gain increased critical hit damage. Whenever Flak's pet scores a critical hit, Flak's next shot deals bonus damage based on their weapon's damage. And that part I didn't really use, but down below it says pet critical hit damage plus 70%, bonus damage 70% of weapon damage. So yeah, those are some huge bonuses. This one also was a big help when I just wanted to send my pet in and have him do everything. This is woolly armor. While Flak's shields are full, their pet gains damage reduction, and that's a reduction of plus 75%, so that's very helpful. Also, my loadout was set up where all the enemies attacked the loader bot and not me, so I just stood back in a corner and was safe with a full shield, and it was giving him a plus 75% damage reduction the whole time. This next one was absolutely insane and extremely overpowered. It's called Not Even a Challenge. It says, whenever Flak's pet kills an enemy, Flak gains increased action skill duration and action skill cooldown rate for a short time. This effect stacks. So I had this set up with the action skill that's Gamma Burst. So whenever your pet is in Gamma Burst, they do a ton of damage. And this was keeping the loader bot in Gamma Burst for a really long time. And I'll show you guys more about how all of that works in the video that shows the actual build. This next one is also very helpful, Fuzzy Math. Whenever Flak or their pet scores a critical hit, a portion of Flak's and their pet's shields are restored. When this is maxed out with 5 points, you get 15% of max shields restored. This one I didn't use. It's called Keep Them Safe. Whenever Flak issues an attack command, if Flak's or their pet's shield is less than half full, a portion of Flak's and their pet's shields are restored. This skill has a short cooldown. The shield restore is 50% of max shields, and the cooldown is 12 seconds. The last one at the bottom of the skill tree for 1 point is called Capacitance. Whenever Flak activates their action skill, they gain greatly increased shield capacity for a short time and immediately begin recharging their shields. The skill has a short cooldown. It gives you plus 100% shield capacity, duration of 16 seconds, and a cooldown of 16 seconds. This one was definitely helpful for my build because I was using the action skill as much as possible. This next one I haven't got to mess with a whole lot because I've been focusing on this loader bot build, and that's been taking up all my time. Also, I noticed it wasn't as useful as the other action skills, but again, I haven't spent a lot of time with it, so there might be a way to trick it out to make it really amazing. I'm sure there's going to be a very useful application for it, but basically it says Flak tosses out a trap that knocks up and temporarily stuns nearby enemies. After being deployed, the trap periodically continues to knock up and stun enemies for the duration. It also says you can actually pick up the trap, and you can pick it up early, and it will refund you a portion of the remaining duration. The duration of the trap is 16 seconds and cooldown is 36 seconds. Now for the augments for the trap, it says whenever an enemy trapped by Flak is knocked into the air, they drop ammo, health boosters, and shield boosters. The next one down is Wide Net. It helps to increase trap duration and trap radius. This next one could be interesting, called Trap Card. It says if Flak would go into Fight for Your Life while their trap is readied, they automatically throw a trap at the enemy that downed them, and the duration of it is 16 seconds. The last one on the bottom for the trap augments is called Blind with Anger. Basically what it does is instead of knocking up enemies into the air, it turns enemies into allies and they start attacking each other. That one could also be very interesting. Now for my favorite part, the upgrades to the loader bot. First we have the bull loader. This one's not my favorite, but it is still really awesome. So what this does is it turns the ion loader into a bull loader. Instead of having a shock sniper, it's given a shotgun, but the shotgun does not have any elemental ability. However, the bull loader will get increased damage resistance and a powerful roundhouse melee attack. Now, I used this bull loader a little bit, and I never saw him really do this roundhouse melee attack. I definitely want to see that happen, so I'm going to have to play with it a little bit more. Also, while you have this bull loader as the pet, it increases Flak's shield capacity, and it is a plus 20% for the shield. Also, whenever Flak issues an attack command, the bull loader briefly turns into a bulldozer and will charge the enemy that Flak has attached the attack command to, and it will knock up the enemies in the air, and sometimes it will kill them. So this one's my favorite, and the one I used in my build, it's called the war loader. So it turns the ion loader into a war loader, and then it gives it an incendiary shotgun and grenades, and the grenades that it throws is the ones that you have equipped. And with my build, I had fastball grenades, grenades equipped, and this warloader was doing anywhere from 60 to 70 million damage with one grenade on one enemy. Also, I preferred this attack command. Whenever you do an attack command on one of the enemies, it will shoot a barrage of missiles at the target, doing anywhere from like 4 to 8 million damage, and most of the time just killing whatever you've targeted. This also increases the fire rate. It is a plus 12%, and that is very helpful. There are three animations that the bot will do when you interact. He'll give you the love hearts, he'll do 360 degrees of fireworks, and then also draw a heart in the air, which is my favorite. Also, and I don't know if they're going to change and update this, but when you go to change your skin, typically your pet will reflect what you're wearing, and he does, but he only shows the colors of the skin and not the actual patterns. Like right here in the menus, it looks like he's wearing the tiger outfit, but in game it just shows him wearing the color combination of that pattern. So here's the ion loader, and he's gonna shoot that electrical orb, and it shows that you can shoot it, and yeah, it will explode and do a nova and kill or damage everything around it. Right here, I've issued an attack command, and he's gonna fire off that orb, and it's going to home in on that enemy. It does knock him in the air. It doesn't kill him, but still, it's pretty powerful. This is the basic version of the loader bot, and it is pretty powerful with this shock sniper. He does a lot of damage, so if that's the option you want, yeah, this one's pretty good. Here is the first upgrade to the ion loader. This is the bull loader, and with the attack command, he will turn into a bulldozer. You do have to make sure he's close enough to an enemy before you issue the command, or he won't go into bulldozer mode. But yeah, this one gives you a boost to your shields, and he doesn't take as much damage, and he also has just a shotgun with no elemental ability. And with the attack command and the bulldozer, he can do a lot of damage. Right here, he's about to do 17 million damage to this skag. Again, I've got a pretty good loadout, and I am on Mayhem 11. His shotgun is extremely powerful, and he's about to bulldozer another skag, and the damage that comes up is 5 million and 18 million. So yeah, he is pretty powerful. Although the bulldozer ability is really effective, I find it difficult to use because you need to have enough spacing, and you got to make sure there's not debris in the way. I mean, it's not difficult to use, but the next bot upgrade has a different type of attack command that I find more useful. So this is the warloader, and his attack command is a barrage of missiles, and he is much more accessible to enemies that are far away or are behind barriers, whereas the bulldozer needs clearance in a certain distance. And this attack command ability is so good in the takedowns and against really tanky bosses. And my build is set up where all the enemies target him. So if there's one enemy that's causing a problem, I'll just target that with missiles and take care of it so that it doesn't bother him. Also, this warloader comes equipped with a shotgun that has incendiary damage, so that is really helpful. And then he's given a grenade, and you get to choose what kind of grenade he throws by the one that you put in your loadout. And like I mentioned before, the damage that he does with a grenade is like 60 to 70 million at a time. It's absolutely crazy. And the amount of damage he can do with a shotgun with one bullet, I've seen 259 million. This is where he one-shotted Captain Trant. So yeah, this loader bot build is a whole lot of fun to take into the takedowns. Anyways, I've got videos coming on that and videos coming on this build, but hopefully this helped you guys out, and we'll see you next video.